shepherd. And that we explained a few things for those of you who were not here. We said that David wrote the psalm, and the reason why David wrote the psalm was that there are certain things that David was going through. And one of the things we first and foremost we realize is David recognized God as his good shepherd. He said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." In other words, he will not lack anything. And I took my time to explain what it means by "you shall not want." And he said, it went on, verse 2, he said, "He maketh me to lie down in green pastures." And I said, your leaves will not wither. You will always lie in green pastures. You will always receive fresh anointing. Every shepherd tries to take the flocks or the sheep to a place where there is fresh food. It is not always the old food that the sheep need to eat. And I said that every pastor always needs to prepare to bring fresh revelation and fresh anointing from the word of the Lord. I cannot bring the good shepherd the whole year. No, you have to always bring different topics and different word of the Lord in order to nourish the congregation. So he said that, and what? He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. How do you feel when you lie on the grass that has been cut fresh? You feel good. And that is what God is going to make you lie on. And then it went further to say that what? He leadeth me beside the what? The still waters. And I say that every sheep, watch it, sheep don't drink from a troubled water. Any water that is troubled, the sheep will not drink from it. The sheep always drink from a still water. And that is how Christians, you don't go and walk and find trouble. You stay out of trouble. Come on, somebody, are you here with me? You stay out of trouble so that when the enemy comes, God, who is your adventure, will revenge on behalf of you. So when the sheep is here and the water is running and is disturbed and the ripples are too much, the sheep will not drink. It will wait until the water is still. Why? Because the sheep do not know whether there is a crocodile or any other animal under the water. And once there is a disturbance of water, it is very hard for you to know what is under the water. But once everything is still, somebody listen, you can look under the water and see where the fishes and everything is.
Yeah.
And we didn't stop there, but we went further. Verse 3 says, "He restored my soul." And I said, why did David write this? Because David at times feel lonely. All the brethren eating all the food and everything in the house, but they left David alone to lead the sheep to the what? To the desert place. And sometimes you understand what I'm talking about. Sometimes you sit and you like, I'm feeling bored. I want to go to the movies. I need somebody to talk to. I want something to go on in my life. And sometimes even if you do not take care, this kind of moodiness can really get you into trouble. But David said that it is the Lord that restored our soul. Somebody listen, the best person to chat with, the best person to talk with, the best person to communicate with is God. And through his word. So if you are feeling bored, somebody listening, you need to take the word and read it. Somebody came on Facebook and said that I'm feeling bored. And another person answered her and said that call your husband then. Call your husband then. Because he's the only person that will cherish you. But the question lies, if you do not have a husband, who do you talk to? Somebody, are you here with me? Am I making sense? He restored my soul, because David has been rejected. Instead of him feeling like I am going to be accepted, all the brethren, everything David said is negative unto them, and they have what? Relegated him to the background, and they have sidelined David. So sometimes David sits there and wonder, do I even have brethren, and am I alone? But in times when I feel lonely, he takes the harp and begins to play. And the Bible says that through the song that David sang, God restored what? His soul. May God restore your soul.
Amen.
Somebody did it. I said, God restore your soul.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. May God restore your soul. Or may he restore your soul. And the Bible said that, what? He leaded me in the path of what? Righteousness. And I said, God will order your steps in his word. He will not lead you into a place where righteousness will not be found. In other words, where there is no edification coming, God will not take you there. God will not take you from the church in order to take you into the world, the club. No, he has not brought me this far to lead me.
Yeah.
I love that song. I was telling a sister this week, I just can't work now against the man. Something. Nobody told me the road won't be easy. By what?
I don't believe
he brought me this far to lead me. God will never do that.
Amen.
He won't bring you this far to lead you. If God has started a good work in you, he leaded me in the path of righteousness. Every step that you take in the Lord, God will order you.
Amen.
In his word.
Amen.
Every fulfillment in your life.
Amen.
Somebody, are you here with me?
Amen.
I said, he didn't take you out of Egypt to bring you to the what? Into the desert to leave you. He didn't take you out of where you are to bring you here in order for you to suffer and not have your purpose. I pray in the name of Jesus that your document should be released by the divine power from above. Hallelujah. I pray that every business that you put your hand in, it shall flourish by the divine power. I pray that your marriage that is not working, it shall work. I pray that every step you take, which cometh from above, in the name of Jesus, may God lead you through righteousness that you fulfill.
Amen.
His will in your life. Come on, somebody. Are you here with me? Ah, look at somebody and say, I shall make it. Oh, I didn't hear you. Tell the person, I shall make it. You will make it to come with me. In the name of Jesus. Ha! Look into your Bible. And it says, for his name's sake, yea, though I walk through the valley of the what? Shadow of death. You walk through. And I explain to you, sometimes it feels like when you're walking, there are images, there are spirits talking to you. You wanted to go this direction. Something is pulling you towards this direction. And thank God for last month, for we bring certain generational cases. Like the deacon said, in this place, I am telling you, I was here when he came and said, Pastor, it seems as if all the documents I need for my kids, I've lost. I said, hold on, let us have patience. The only thing we can do is to have patience and pray about it. Look, God is a God of all possibilities. It doesn't matter how the enemy wants to frustrate you. If God be with you, who can be against you? Nobody. Nobody can be against you. Nobody can be against you. You can't sleep under this anointing. Those of you sleeping, wake up, wake up, wake up. Hallelujah. I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. If you walk through the valleys of the shadow of death, no evil shall befall you, because the Lord is with you. Hallelujah. Isaiah 41:10. Fear not, do not be dismayed, for I, the Lord, I will hold you and uphold you with what? My right hand. Last week, I said the right hand stands for great what? Authority. So I want you to understand, somebody, this morning, that look, don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. Everything that is surrounding you is telling you, look, you will fail, but you are not failing.
No.
Sister, you are not failing.
Yeah.
At the point in time, when everything is speaking to you about your failure, you also speak your way out. Somebody, are you here with me? I said, you have to learn how to do what? Speak your way out of the situation.
Amen.
Some of us will cry. You cry and cry and cry. And the devil sits down and crosses his leg. Say, yes, I got her. I got her. It's time not to cry anymore.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It's time to arise. And possess your what? Possessions. God has made everything possible for us. Somebody listen. And I was preaching this Wednesday that passed. And Gideon told the Lord in Judges 6 that if you have made everything possible for us, then why are we struggling? Yeah. Why are we going through this persecution and tribulation? The last time I spoke about the perfect will and the what? And the permissive will. Somebody are here with me?
Yeah.
Listen. If you don't or you have forgotten, let me rephrase everything so that you can get it once again. Permissive will is something that is not in the concept and the plans, the purposes, the aims, and the objectives of God concerning your life. But God still has to allow it. So if you read Genesis chapter 1, the Bible says that, and the children of God, or the children of Israel, went out of line and started serving other gods. And started doing their own thing. And God permitted the Midianites to come and torment them for 7 years. God permitted. And sometimes that is what happened in our lives. It is not anything that is in the plan and the purpose of God, but God has to allow, because that is what you want. That's why God don't make any mistake again. Somebody, are you here with me? God do not make any mistake. After God gave Adam and then the sin, when God came and asked, hey, Adam, where are you? He said, Lord, it's not me, it's the lady that you gave me. And then God went to the lady and said, lady, didn't I tell you not to eat the apple? The lady said, oh no, God, not me. In this rule, it is deceptive. Everybody is shifting blame. Who wants to accept the blame? See how it is? God said, oh, is that how it's going to be? From now on, I'm not going to make that mistake again. I'm not going to choose any husband for a man again. So if you read the Bible very well, Bible said, God leave us alone. So you have to go and find your bed and lay on your bed. If your bed is hard, it is your own problem. You will have what? Whatever walking you walk. If your bed is soft, you wake up and then you feel good. And you begin to smile and say, oh. And when I say bed, I'm talking about a lady that you have to go and search. If the lady is blah, 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 then I want you to know that you will be swallowed. Mm-hmm. And you will go through the storms with her. But if that bed is soft, if she understands, can flow with you, then everything will be right. Vice versa. The lady also, you have to find your man. If you are there and the man come, yes, you find one. But the key thing is that if that man is popular matter and he has turned himself to be only in the holy field and is using your face as a punching bag, boom, boom, you better know what kind of decision you have to take. Because you didn't want to marry an Ibada Holyfield in order for your face all to be turned into the what? To be a masquerade.
Woo! That's deep one.
Thank you, Deacon. It's up to you.
Amen.
Everybody goes through the storms. Everybody. But we don't give up.
Don't give up.
I was just saying this week, I didn't have even $20 in my pocket. I'm telling you, I didn't have anything in that. Does it mean that I don't have some things to do? Yes. But I have to wait patiently.
Yeah.
I have to wait patiently. Whatever you are going through, sometimes you need to wait upon God.
Wait upon the Lord.
Because there's coming a time when you come here and you cry on me. This church has grown. Wherever God has led us and we are in a greater number, I will not sit down because I have a heart that I cannot look for certain things to happen unto God's children. I said, sister, come on, give me a high five. When you give me a high five and a shaking like this, oh, what is going to come into your hands? You say, oh my goodness, sir, he left $1,000 in my head, sir. You can't even do anything. Say, pastor, please, God bless you. Bless you.
Yeah.
Bless you. Because that is the kind of love we show for one another.
Amen.